My presentation is on production of e-resources. Yesterday, I discussed about the platform on which our country used to curate the e-resources, various e-resources. So, how these e-resources is produced, I will tell you today. First of all, what is an e-resource? E-resource is an digital object that can identified with an appropriate use for it into the given teaching learning context. That means the teaching learning context will be able to identify with through which we can teach. That will be an e-resource. And the e-resources could be an audio clip, video clip, or the image, or any document, example, or the combination of above of the any of the clippings or anything. So these are some examples of e-resources. And how does this e-resources is created in our organization and in our country? It is, we use the ADDIE model basically, that is analysis, design, development, implementation, and evaluation. So, if we start with the part of analysis, first of all, we try to identify the content on which the various resources have to be created. We should know who is the target audience, whether that resource has to be created for a teacher or for a student. Accordingly, we select our theme, and on that basis, we should identify what type of resources we want to create. After analyzing all these, we start with the designing part. We just draft a brief script, a draft script with a storyline, and that the sequence is provided in which the content will be organized. And after drafting that brief script, we have our own production division. Who are the different producers, we can say directors, to suggest us how we can create, whether it is feasible or not. And on the basis of that, we develop the storyboard, first of all. And a complete script is created. And we discuss with the production team. The script is discussed with the production team, and it is sent for the production part. And we have our own studio setup, where we have a team like cameraman, the makeup artist, the set designer, the graphic artist, who help in all the production of the resources. And after the production takes place, we implement it. That means the final video or audio program is sent for the field testing in the schools, where the student and teachers directly view and give us a suggestion. And on the basis of that suggestion, we evaluate the resource, and then we disseminate to various like platforms, to our website. And I have shown you one of the websites yesterday. So I will try to share the screen if possible. I don't know whether it is possible or not, like earlier. Let me just see. Are you able to see my screen? Are you able to see my screen? Hello? Screen. So this is the website to which we disseminate our all the resources. So yesterday I want to show you the demo. This is the website by NROEA, where we have created all the e-library, and in that under that e-library we have got all the content uploaded, whether it is an audio resource, the video resource, I think we need e-resources. Like if I see any resource, that resources can be used by, like it's an audio resource. So that resource can be. So this is an audio resource. So we can easily download it and use it. So this is a complete process how the e-resources could be created and how it is shared to the across the nation, across the world. This is my presentation on e-resources. Thanks a lot.